All right, welcome back to the Balance Ahead of Entertainment this morning. Now, if you check your agogo, you can see the next level will be on top. Now, the one we're concerned, this very lovely, beautiful, in fact, beautiful, is an understatement on top of this particular guest where I get. But make I just read her profile. She now from Kumi local government area for inside Taraba State, and born for inside 21st of October. And she now the last born of her picking them. But right now, she don't become the first lady to win the National Beauty Pageant from the northern part of Nigeria. Now she's school for inside Lagos, where they actually born am. And now she be the first, she don't become the first Miss Javi before graduating. She also go the junior secondary school for inside Nigeria. She actually attend the Nigerian Navy Secondary School for Ojo, and she don't waka go inside higher education to study law. Help me make welcome Beauty to Kura in our studio. Welcome this morning.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Morning. Now, with the you don't win. First of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
On top of the Miss Nigeria, we know say you know they're easy. Of all the participants waiting for the year, they actually decide to crown you based on your performance for inside. But make I ask you, from the very beginning, from the very first time where you hear about them, you ever think, say, you go reach this level you did also?
It was just a dream. Now, dream might be the dream, but I mean, today it's a reality, and that's why I'm sitting here. Miss Nigeria for me started when I was 4 years old. Yeah, I was watching the Miss Nigeria TV on the Miss Nigeria pageant on TV with my parents, and I just turned and told my dad, I said, one day I'm going to be Miss Nigeria. You know, so I said it like a joke. Everyone thought I was joking, and in my house, they started calling me Miss Nigeria, Miss Nigeria, Miss Nigeria. My uncle would even say Miss World, you know. And well, in my primary school, I contested, I won. Then later on in my years, I contested for the Most Beautiful Girl Taraba. I won. I reigned for 2 years. And I wanted to do Miss Nigeria when I was in university, but my dad would always say, no, finish school, that's more important. And today I understand why he said that, and I'm glad that I waited until I was done.
Beautiful. Now, we know say this journey, the journey on top of pageantry, it'll be an easy one. Tell us some of the things where you actually passed through, some of the challenges, especially when you meet the other girls for inside this competition. We know say when you're in the midst of girls, a lot of things, they come out, a lot of insecurities on your pathway, things that you feel hide. Yeah. You know, so tell us some of this, the journey so far, some of the sweet side, some of the not so sweet side as well on top of this journey.
Okay, the journey so far has been interesting. I hope you don't mind me switching to English.
Feel free.
Okay. So the journey so far has been interesting. I mean, it's just like you said, when you meet girls from different states in Nigeria, everyone is different. And I must say, this last set, the girls were fire. Like, they were intelligent, they were ready. You know, when we have talks in camp, everybody's on fire and you're just speaking, debate. It was really hot. Sometimes I wish Miss Nigeria would bring out that part so people can actually see that there's more to the catwalk on stage. So it was really challenging. Also, convincing my parents to let me do this because they were concerned. They're like, beauty pageantry in Nigeria, it's like this, there's a stereotype. Are you sure that these ones are different? You know, how can we trust them? Are you going to be safe? You know, and it's normal for parents to feel like that. So these were some of the challenges that I faced that's outside of camp, you know, from where I was coming from. But I was able to prove to them. And just yesterday, my sister was saying, oh, I'm so happy that you actually did this. And for me, you've changed the narrative. I got a message yesterday too when I posted a video of me during an interview, and someone said, you are really changing the narrative. Like, since you won, it's not really about showcasing your body, it's more about the intelligence. And that's what I'm trying to let people know, that for beauty pageantry, there's more to it than meets the eye. It's not about what you see. Because if you look at me, I have scars on my body. So it's not about how flawless your skin is, it's not about how beautiful you are, it's about what's up here. Because as a queen, you should be intelligent, you should be elegant. So it's just,
I like what you talk. You should be intelligent and you should be elegant. Now, let's talk about the project where you get as the beauty queen. Because we know, say, for every queen, during her reign, she's supposed to do one or two things. Tell us some of the projects where you don't decide to embark on and what make you actually start those projects.
Okay, so Miss Nigeria has a mother company called the Green Girl Company. And they have three initiatives. So we have the Green Girl Academy, we have the Raising Girls Summit, and Miss Nigeria. So the Green Girl Academy is an academy that empowers girls in Africa through entrepreneurship, education, empowerment, you know, health, different areas. And they do that by programs, trainings, courses. And so for this year, we want to focus on the entrepreneurship side. And we're seeing how we can carefully pick 10 girls from different charities, in collaboration with charities and from homes, girls who actually need the impact of this initiative, girls who are intelligent, and we want to train them for vocational schools. Schools, trainings in cosmetology, tailoring, catering, and you know, the plan is to cater for them and give them stipends. Doing this, it's going to be a 12-month course, so we're going to be giving them stipends every month while they're taking this course. And we also want to go further to send them to the Diamond School of Protocol and Etiquette for a startup training on entrepreneurship, so that they have both the theory and the practical, and after empower them with the tools that they need to set them up. So that's one project. And another project under the Raising Girls Summit, this time around, we're focusing on health. Last year, they had the seminar, and they focused squarely on STEM. So this year, we're shifting it to health. And we're going to be collaborating with some national laboratories to carry out a pap test. It's supposed to help you check for signs of cancer in your cervix and all that. And we're targeting the three geopolitical zones. So maybe one in the north, one in the east, one in the west. And our target is universities, so that we can get more girls, you know, because, I mean, a university is a large place, so you can meet people, because we're targeting girls from 16 to 30. So these are some of the projects that we have in mind for the next 10 months.
For the next 10 months.
Yes.
Beautiful. Now, looking at the beauty pageantry, we get some myth where some people, they come outside, they talk. I mean, and which we need to come out and debunk. Because now, just as you talk, they come outside, they change the narrative for inside beauty pageantry for inside Nigeria. So tell us some of the things where we hear. Because some things, make I ask this way. Okay. Some things that we hear of. Say, for inside the pageantry, there's lobbying. For inside the pageantry. So how was that for you, looking at the way where you be here before you enter inside the house, before you actually participate fully? Tell us some of the myths where you actually hear from outside, but where you don't come outside.
I won't sit here and tell you that all pageants are fair and square, because then I'd be lying. Mm-hmm. But what I can say is, for every young girl that wants to partake in a pageantry, I always tell them, do your research. I've been following Miss Nigeria for almost 10 years of my life. You know, constantly keeping up with their activities, and not just their page, I try to follow up with their past queens too. You know, I try to see what's the process like. So you always have to do your research. And I'll tell you that I didn't pay anybody a dime to do anything concerning this pageant. And Miss Nigeria is even one of the best pageants, and I say that because the forms are even free. Yeah, it's free. You just go online, you fill it, and they email you. And when it's time for auditions, you go for audition. So just like every other thing, there's a process to being Miss Nigeria. And that's why I said sometimes I wish those clips could come out. Because it's from you filling the form, you go for your audition, there are online tags. From the online tags, you go to camp. In camp, there are tags every day, different activities, you know. And then what people see and the one they enjoy is just the coronation, where we come out in our gowns and, you know, we're smiling and looking all
pretty,
beautiful.
Yeah. You know.
So there's a process to it, and there's no lobbying. I get messages like that on Instagram, and people are like, oh, what did you do? Please give me connect. And I'm like, girl, you have to go and do your research. You need to prepare. If you know you want this, you need to start preparing. You need to keep up. You need to be aware of how they run. Let me give you an example. Unlike some pageantries, Miss Nigeria is very decent, if you notice. They keep up that moral side of the Nigerian culture. So you can't be running for Miss Nigeria, no offense. You are exposing yourself on social media and all that. When you contest, they go through your page, they look at all these things. And this is a free tip I'm giving to every other girl who intends to contest for next year. You know, they're looking at this thing. So you need to be prepared. When I say prepared, it's not just about your head. Your social media, you need, everything needs to be aligning with what you're going for. It's just like you saying you want to go and fly a plane and you don't go for the training.
Beautiful.
So
now, just as you talk training, you just bring me to the next one where they think of, and that one concerns your educational qualification.
Yes.
Because you study law, or I mean, you decide to say in a law, now wait till you want to study for school. And right now, you're a beauty queen. I'm trying to imagine a beauty queen wearing black and white.
Ooh.
For inside court of law.
I know.
How you want to take balance, or how you they take balance those two different paths entirely?
Well, I haven't been called to bar yet.
Okay.
So I'm looking forward to going to law school soon. A lot of people ask me if I want to practice law. Yes, I'm still going to practice. But what people don't know is you can practice law in different ways. There's litigation. That's people who go to court and wear the wig and gown every time. You know, there are company lawyers. There are people who just partner with law firms, you know, and bring clients on retainership. So there are different ways to practice law. And a lot of people don't even know that there's entertainment law too.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I always advise artists, anybody I know is saying, oh, I'm a celebrity, do you have a lawyer? You know, these things are vital. So there are different ways to practice law. It's not just litigation.
Now, law, you actually won't read for school?
Yes.
You've always wanted to read law?
Yes.
Beautiful. Okay, so now we don't finish. So tell us your life after winning this pageantry compared to the life where you get before. Because some people, they come outside, they talk, say, ah, once you be celebrity, you get some kind of places where you know they enter, you know. You get some kind of mama put you in a go-go walk. You get some kind of, guys, you go take the chop on my life. If they didn't take chop on my life before, now you have to use the cutlery to take your amala, you know. So, has there been so much of that change? Tell and give us one or two examples.
Well, don't worry, we say it's amala, but we just do it with fork and knife.
Now we're talking.
Well, I haven't. For me, I'd say I've really tried to still stay in character, but just a better version of myself.
Okay.
Because sometimes we tend to lose ourselves trying to, you know, just get into the fame side of the whole thing. And I'm trying not to do that. I still want to be me and still be able to carry out my responsibilities. But a lot has changed, actually. I mean, I watched my followers on Instagram go from 5,000 to 11 point something K in how many days? And I'm like, what? And you know, my request is crazy. I have a lot of girls there messaging me, oh, what did you do? Want to be like you? Can you mentor me? And I think mentorship is something we should actually take up in Nigeria, because I've actually seen too many messages on that. They're like, oh, can you mentor me? I need advice. I want to do this. I want to do that. Oh, I look up to you. So, I mean, my life has changed. When I go out, okay, the other day, for example, I was just running errands. And two girls actually ran into me and they were like, I noticed them looking at me from the car. But I was like, I was like, why are these girls looking at me? Do they recognize me? And I was still trying to cover because
so, like,
that day
hides
I was,
more.
Yeah, I was trying to hide. And next thing they came out, they're like, sorry, can we have a picture? I'm like, oh, my hair is not done. I'm just going to stand there. Like, we don't mind. And you know, they actually took the picture and posted it and tagged me. So yes, a lot has changed, but the best thing is it's just a better version of me.
Beautiful. So now for people with the other really young girls, we will know, say, just as you talk, did they look up to you for mentorship or some form of advice? Now waiting to be the, for somebody will be fresh, she just wants start or just want enter inside this particular industry of pageantry, waiting you go fit to tell them as per the advice to give precisely.
Okay, So every young girl out there who wants to be a beauty queen like myself, I'd like to tell you to, first of all, know why. That question is very important. Because if you don't know why you want to do it, you go about doing it the wrong way. So you need to ask yourself why. And when you've been able to answer that question, begin to work actively towards it. If you audition, they don't pick you, it's fine. Keep doing what you're doing. But whatever you do, make sure that you're preparing yourself for that role. For example, go to school. You don't have to leave school because you want to be a beauty queen. Go to school. It'll help boost your ego. You know, when you come in the midst of the other girls, you feel more confident about yourself. So go to school. Make active work on yourself. When I say active work, I mean your body structure. Don't get me wrong. Miss Nigeria is open to all body types, but sometimes it's better if your feet, you know, it makes you stand out more. So just take up a lifestyle that leads you to your dream.
Beautiful. It's not all about slaying on social media.
Oh, but still slay, though.
Of course you can. Thank you so much. And wish you the very best on top of your
Thank
project.
You.
All right, that's all. See, I'm on top of the Balance Diet Entertainment this morning. You don't see the beauty queen herself on top of the 43rd edition, Miss Nigeria. Now, we don't interview. So for more information, how can they get you on social media?
Oh, my Instagram handle is @beautytokura. And then there's @MissNigeriaOrganization. So my activities are posted on both pages, both the Miss Nigeria page and my personal page. I'm also on Facebook, @BeautyEtaInTokura. I'm on Twitter, @BTokura. So you can reach me there.
Beautiful. You know, here are the handles where you can actually get more information. On top of the beauty pageant world, and on top, follow her for more information on how to move on.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.